Hello everyone, welcome back to the Jump Force Character Reviews. I told you to expect another one of these, and today we are finally covering our first new Yu Haka Show character. We're covering the main character of the franchise, Yusuke Urameshi, aka the Spirit Detective. Let me make sure I mute this while we go forward. So, Yusuke is a demon. Specifically, a half-demon, essentially, who lives in a demon world. Basically, a world that is more durable than ours. For his fighting style, he's part brawler, but he uses his demon energy. He seems to have a decent kit, and I honestly think he's kind of underrated. But there's good reasons why people don't really play Yusuke that much. Let's talk about more of that once we get into some gameplay, shall we? Yusuke is mostly a close-range combatant. Keyword being mostly. He does have one range move, which is also his support move, which is the move that everyone probably knows from the show Yu Yu Hakusho, if you remember that despite it being from the 1990s. And there it is, Spirit Gun, or as Yusuke calls it, Ray Gun. Don't ask me why, I'm pretty sure Ray is not the Japanese version of Spirit. Just like a detective, he pulls out his own version of a firearm, specifically a demon firearm that launches demon energy at you. Costs 1 meter and has a pretty decent range, and you can even use it after a grab, kind of similar to Boa's Pistol Kiss. Pretty weird to have the characters who have a gun move in their arsenal with their fingers can actually use it after a grab. Kind of weird, but also kind of neat. Second move we saw earlier was his launcher attack, Spirit Wave. I'm not a huge fan of Spirit Wave that much. It sounds like a decent move on paper, costing, you know, only 1 meter. But the problem is that it actually has a hitbox in the air. So basically you have to launch your phone in the air before you can hit them with it, and then you can send them flying. It's got pretty decent knockback distance on it, so you can definitely use a character who has longer range on it. But I wouldn't really recommend it that much because it's not my favorite launcher in the game. And personally, I'm not sure you can find a use for. Like I said, Yusuke, being a close-range combatant, also needs to have a very close-range move. And his last move, which is going to be great for combos, essentially, is Organ Murder. It'll cost you 2 meter, but you start in a headbutt stance, and it is an unblockable attack. Yay, another character with an unblockable move. That's two in a row that we've covered. But basically, Organ Murder will basically turn your opponent into a human punching bag. You headbutt them once, and then you beat the crap out of him. And here is his ult, Spirit Gun Mega, where he dashes forward, knocks you in the air, and he shoots you. It's even kind of like a simple Ryu Shinko Hadouken, essentially. Just a more amplified version of his already good enough attack. So, what would I recommend for Yusuke? Well, my big issue with Yusuke is that a lot of his combos are pretty simple, pretty basic, and you can't really do really long combos with Yusuke. All of his moves are pretty much good combo enders, but that's it. He's got nothing that helps extend those combos, really. He's more of a finisher rather than an extender. So someone who can help you extend those combos with multiple hits might not be a bad idea. You can use either a dasher or someone who can hit multiple times their attacks, such as Gaara. Doesn't do that bad for Yusuke. Oddly enough, Togoro is not that great, oddly, ever since they nerfed his running speed with Stronger. So you can probably get away with using somebody like Sasuke or even Naruto. Maybe Kenshin might not be that bad. You want someone that can amplify more damage, this way you can do more damage in your combos. So what is wrong with Yusuke? Well, the reason he's not that pick is because there's only really one decent move that he has, and it's Spirit Gun. Not to mention his transformation of his demon form, also known as Raisin, doesn't do a whole lot for Yusuke besides making the attacks look slightly more menacing and changing his attitude. Yeah, here's his demon form right here. Looks pretty cool, but unfortunately it doesn't add anything besides a complete change of personality. In fact, using a compare and contrast of the alt you saw earlier and this version. The attitude of Yusuke also changes, which is kind of neat of a detail that they had. Alright, so to continue what I was saying, his combos are short, but they don't do that much by themselves. You definitely need someone that can help you extend those combos if you can. Not to mention that Yusuke's Spirit Gun is okay. Sure, you can dodge a little bit and move to fire your shot, but there are other characters that have something similar, like Piccolo's Special Beam Cannon, oddly enough, even though I don't really use it that much. I feel like Yusuke is a little bit one-dimensional of his playstyle. It's either you can shoot at long range with Spirit Gun, or you can try to do something up close. However, I prefer him over some of the other close-range combatants, oddly enough, because Organ Murder is actually a pretty good move. Would I recommend Yusuke for you guys to play? Kinda and no. But I would say if you want to try Yusuke, go for it. He's not the best close-range combatant, but he is better than some of the other ones we have covered in the game. Mostly because Spirit Gun is a really helpful move for him to have, especially as a support attack. Not to mention his ult does cover quite a bit of distance. As for a rating of Yusuke, as much as I like the Spirit Detector being added to the game, I do have to be honest, he's only a 6.5. The only reason he gets slightly higher than someone else who's a close range combatant like Deku is because Spirit Gun is a much better move than Detroit Smash. Not to mention that Raisin actually does a little bit of things too. Well, that's gonna do it for Yusuke Urameshi the Spirit Detective. I hope you folks enjoyed this review and let me know what you think of Yusuke personally down below. We are covering the other Yu Yu Hakusho characters. Togoro, aka the younger brother, we'll get more into that once we do cover him, which will be sometime next week, probably early next week. And we're still trying to work out some stuff for, of course, Madara, Todoroki, and probably some other characters coming soon. I gotta figure out what I want to do since I already covered the JoJo characters. With that being said, I will see you all later. When I get to